Good morning. I am a career coach, and I coach senior-level executives. I received a call not too long ago from a prospective coaching client, and he began by stating, I was part of the innovation group, and we created a new concept that generated $1 billion in net new revenue in the first 2 years. We also created another new concept, and the company told me that based on the success of that new concept, I had proven to them that continued expansion in the retail sector was unlimited. I interrupted him and asked, with all of that success, why are we talking today? And his answer, my entire group was eliminated. The company had to take all of its efforts and resources to fend off a fast-growing competitor that was jeopardizing the core business and putting thousands of jobs at risk. And another call started, like so many do. I never saw it coming. I was with this one company for 16 years. I've never looked for a job. I don't know where to begin. I don't even have a resume. I was promoted every 2 or 3 years. And I made it to SVP Global Sales. But the company couldn't bring a vital new product to market fast enough. And so they did what they had to do and sold to our biggest rival. It saved hundreds of jobs, but they didn't need 2 SVPs of Global Sales. These stories echo daily. There is no more long tenure and no more gold watches. Today, what you need is a Fitbit to remind you, actually pressure and remind you to keep moving and remain nimble. Because today, speed, agility, flexibility, and adaptability are what count. I want you to leave here today thinking differently, because I believe that, like it or not, every role is a gig, and you are all part of the gig economy. Whether you are on a salary and get a W-2 at the end of the year, or a freelancer, today often known as a gigger. Why do I say every role is a gig and you're all part of the gig economy? According to the Bureau of Labor Statistics, the median tenure today is 4.2 years. And according to the Korn Ferry Institute study for the C-suite, median tenure for the CEO, 8 years. For the CFO, 5.1 years. For the CHRO, 5 years. For the CIO, 4.3. And shortest tenure for the CMO at 4.1 years. And here's why. Disruption is speeding up exponentially. In 1965, when gold watches were still being handed out, the average longevity for a company on the S&P 500 was 33 years. By 1990, just 20 years. And by 2027, it is projected to be just 12 years. That's less than a decade from today. And as you can see from this chart, the gold watch days of 1965 quickly dissipate. And as we come to today and beyond, they are not coming back. So of the top 12 companies of the S&P 500, you see more disruption. Between the year 2000 and 2018, only 4 companies, just 1/3 of the companies on the S&P 500 remained there. And some of those companies were long-standing industry leaders, including General Electric, Intel, and our own Atlanta-based Coca-Cola. And you may have heard of the term unicorns. It was a term coined in 2013 to describe early-stage private companies that had reached $1 billion in valuation. And it was coined because it was such a statistical improbability. But shortly after, this term was coined, decacorns, to acknowledge closely held, fast growth companies that had reached $10 billion in valuation. Companies that you know, like Airbnb and Uber and WeWork. So the truth is that disruption is going to continue. This, with companies like that rising so quickly and succeeding so quickly, disruption is inevitable. It's inevitable for the companies and for the people in the companies and for many of you here. And it's inevitable regardless of industry. This is a disruption that touched many of us. Netflix famously disrupted Blockbuster, who had 25,000 employees when it filed for bankruptcy in 2010. But it had been founded in 1985, so it had 25 years without disruption. But in the short time that Netflix has been on the scene, they have had to disrupt themselves twice in order to remain relevant. They started by putting the DVD in your mailbox, then they disrupted themselves the first time when they started to stream media. And they've disrupted themselves and the entertainment industry again as they have produced original content for movies and television. And they are now in the lead with 100 million hours of television and movies daily being consumed. And in the technology industry, we're quickly seeing the migration from enterprise data centers to the clouds, punctuated most recently by last month's acquisition by IBM of Red Hat for $34 billion. It's a lot of money, but probably a good bet, since the IBM CEO has declared that cloud computing is a $1 trillion emerging industry. And in retail, we no longer buy our books at Borders, our toys at Toys R Us, or get our music from Tower Records. And when those companies went away, thousands of jobs went away too. But what's most relevant for today, retail is striking a resurgence. But as they reinvent themselves, they will not need the same workforce that they had in the past. And disruption is inevitable regardless of performance. You heard that from my clients in the beginning. Careers are disrupted every day, regardless how well an individual performs. And even those companies, the top 100 companies to work for, even those companies like Google, Starbucks, Disney, Kaiser Permanente, they all had layoffs in the last 12 months. They're one of the 100 best companies to work for, but they still have to remain nimble in order to remain relevant. And the change and disruption is coming from all over the world. Of the top 10 companies by revenue in the world, 70% are non-US companies. So it's time for you to disrupt your thinking and to think and act more like a gigger, and to show up more like a gigger, so that you can leverage what giggers know. In a McKinsey study on independent work, they described individuals who were in gigs between their W-2 gigs. They described them as reluctant. But I am here today to turn all reluctance and all of you into gig enthusiasts, because you need to do what companies do and disrupt yourself. You need to take, you put on your Fitbit, take control of your career so that as needed, you can readily and rapidly move from employee to gigger, and if you choose, back again. Because I believe that as a thinking like a gigger, you'll be a better employee in a corporate role in today's turbulent environment. So Let's look at how do giggers think versus how the average executive thinks. So for giggers, they are constantly building their network. And they look for people who have skills that they don't have so that they can partner with them and expand their services for their clients. They carefully and deliberately curate their network. Corporate executives tend to live in a cocoon of connections, mostly in their own company or industry, and maybe they even in their own department. But can you really disrupt yourself if you are not exposing yourself to new ideas from a much broader network? Giggers, when they're asked by their client, can you do this? They say, of course. And then they figure out how. They see every gig as an opportunity for the next gig. And they are always, always, always looking for that next gig. Because they know today's client might be gone tomorrow. Corporate executives, head down in your own lane, hardly ever keeping your next role top of mind. And that next role could be in the next department or the next division, but you don't even look there. But the giggers are looking there. They're sniffing around for new opportunities within those companies. Corporate executives pick their head up and look when they hear the first word of reorganization. And then they're competing with everyone else who's already gotten the same word. Giggers go with the flow. They have to. Projects start and stop. They speed up and they slow down. So they know that, and they remain nimble. Change is the order of the day. Corporate executives, the biggest vulnerability there, they are resistant to change. But when configuring reorganizations, it's the executives who have shown the most ability to adapt that are the ones that are retained. And giggers know that their biggest competitive advantage is staying on the cutting or bleeding edge of their industry, and their clients expect that. They curate their own curriculum. Corporate executives take what the companies are offering, and what they're offering is what's good for the company, not necessarily what's good for you. And giggers have a built-in safety net. Right? They have to so that they can go between gigs. Corporate executives tend to be lured to max out the 401k, but you don't have a 90-day safety net that you can access without penalty. So, how do you disrupt yourself and begin to think and act more like a gigger? Well, first of all, you watch for trends and what's changing in industries and sectors, and you curate a network there. You find the thought leaders. Who do you need to know? And more important, who needs to know you? And you go to events and conferences in those industries. You get outside of your community, outside of your comfort zone, and you curate a forward-facing network. You take control. You develop your own curriculum. You learn what you need to learn to continue to be relevant. And you make sure that you're learning things that keep your mind agile and open for change. And finally, you start today. Open your 401me account. Develop your own safety net. Put on your Fitbit and get moving and leverage what giggers have to teach you. Oh, sorry, gotta move. Thank you.